being the youngest of 11 children, grew up in a household with, you know, from the Beatles, the Stones, to all the soul stuff and the Stax, everything. And so I've sort of become a bit of a hybrid of everything, you know. And, you know, there's been quite a few artists that have made soul records, and I've been asked, you know, why haven't I made one? I sort of always resisted and didn't really want to go down the path of, you know, making an album full of the songs that we all know. So this album is really full of obscure sort of tracks that I've kind of loved over the years, and that, you know, it felt sort of suitable to me, singing-wise, you know. Yeah, having come from bands, you know, you're sort of like locked into a certain thing. You know, as a solo artist, you're able to sort of diversify and try different things. So being the rock singer and then, you know, like doing this record, it's kind of, it's good. I'm really excited about this record. Soul music is, it's not so much soul music, it's about what comes out of you when you're singing, and, you know, your delivery and the whole commitment to this performance, really. And that's what those old soul guys had. That's what made them soulful. And that's what I've tried to capture on this record. I go to the movie and I go downtown, yeah. Yeah, selecting the tracks, I'd been playing a song called A Change Is Gonna Come in my live set. It's an old Sam Cooke song, and people just freaked out when I'd sing that song because it's the blues, you know, and people hadn't really heard me singing that type of music, you know, it's more the rock thing. So that was really the catalyst for getting me to do this, for me doing this record, Testify. Days actual recording time, yeah. It's very intense, actually. I haven't made a record like that in a long time, you know, where it's just in there and bang it out, you know. We weren't really worried about, sonically, about things being perfect, you know. I think a lot of music today, everyone gets so worried about perfect sounds, and I liked all the rough edges, and I like, you know, just getting it to the point where it just feels natural, and, you know, the energy just makes you feel inside and actually do something, you know. So I try to get it to that point, which I think we accomplished, most definitely. Simple though love is. John Fields produced this record, and, you know, John is a multi-instrumentalist, and, you know, played some piano and guitar and stuff, and bass. Michael Bland, who plays with Prince, he played drums. And I had actually Justin Stanley from Noiseworks, who lives in Los Angeles, and he came in to visit me, and I put him to work straight away, you know, get in there and play something. So it was great to have Justin on, because, you know, I mean, Noiseworks put up in 92, and Justin and I haven't been in the studio together probably since then. You know, we set out to make a raw, soulful record, and we avoided all the brass stuff. You know, a lot of songs had brass, and so I didn't want to do any of that. Just want to keep it, you know, basic rhythm section. And guitar based, you know, really, really simple. So when we're doing it live, it's, you know, better live than what it is on the record. That's how I've always operated. I tried to anyway. Because this is a soul record, but it's sort of, you know, more obscure kind of type soul songs, that's what I was trying to find. You know, do you call it soul, this, soul, that? I thought, you know, the Testify, which is an old Johnny Taylor song, which is one of the songs on the record, I thought that was a very good title, considering it's a soul record.